Greetings, people of the world. We are anonymous. It has come to our attention that Monsanto has been polluting and destroying the environment in a way that affects all of us, and it's time to act against these crimes that are disregarding the safety of the human population. On the occasion of the international mobilization against Monsanto Incorporated, we join the efforts of all the groups involved saying stop. Stop GMO production aimed at conquering ever larger market shares. Stop the logic of a market which produces products such as R2, that are resilient to glyphosate produced by Monsanto Incorporated, itself, which are very dangerous for humans. The first documentations about genetic malformations begin to appear in habitats. The overexploitation of the soil caused by pesticides and monoculture in particular, in Paraguay, wealthy landowners of the UGP group use more and more violent methods against citizens who occupy lands entrusted to them by a past agrarian reform. One of the goals of the UGP group is to plant on the lands the kind of genetically modified seeds from Monsanto Incorporated, which are resilient to glyphosate pesticides. Once again we see the environment polluted and destroyed and large companies' interests put before the law and food safety. Once again we see small and very small farmers, whose rights are denied and their lives disrupted in the name of profit. We join the struggle that Vandana Shiva has been carrying on for 30 years against Monsanto and intensive farming with the Nivania Association. Recently in Europe, the EU has reiterated that the country may not prevent the community directives which provide for the introduction of transgenic seeds resistant to glyphosates. This of course will cause the intensive use of the aforementioned carcinogenic pesticides and genetically modified seeds. Let us also note that Monsanto has established the Round Table on Responsible Soy RTRS and the Round Table on Sustainable Palm Oil RSPO. How can transgenic crops, grown by destroying small farmers and the biodiversity that they are protecting, where carcinogenic pesticides, even harmful for the fetus, are employed, be labeled as eco-sustainable? Many areas where Monsanto works are subject to deforestation. This means that, for example, the Amazonic forest has been partly destroyed to make space for Monsanto crops. WWF members with Monsanto representatives participate in associations with RTRS and RSPO, associations that certify that the land where Monsanto grows its crops were subject to sustainable deforestation. We think that it's important to remember the very existence that big areas of the Amazonic forest are already under the threat of hydroelectric projects by many South American states, projects that are being implemented by forcing native populations, the last representative of antique cultures, to abandon their lands and their customs. This is a true ethnic cleansing committed by big brick firms and energy companies against South American natives. For example, in Belo Monte, Brazil, natives are seeing the existence of their very community threatened by the big hydroelectric barrage project of Nordenergia. Against this dam that will flood many hectares of Amazonic forest and will drain the Xingu River, threatening the very existence of many native populations, Operation Green Rights is fighting and will continue to fight. Other lands have been stolen from the Amazonic forest by the RS-163, the way of the biggest traffics on Earth, from cocaine to niobium. With this operation we want to put on the same level Monsanto and a global NGO that we were taught to respect, WWF. We intend to fight against those international crimes that see governmental and non-governmental organizations created and subsidized by multinationals and states, with the goal of increasing a civic sense to fight with morality the most shameful of human actions. Monsanto, WWF, no round table, no eco-sustainable certificate will negate the damage to the forests caused by the intensive farming. Your paper sheets will not make the soil of your crops less damaged by the Roundup, a glyphosate-based pesticide that Monsanto itself produces and uses. Your useless pretended warnings will not compensate the Paraguayan farmer for the violent campaign to expulse them from the properties that the land reform gives them. Monsanto, nothing can hide the social and ecological havoc that the diffusion of your seeds and pesticides is generating globally. We are anonymous. We are a legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.